benefit system.
The campaign to improve the Kansas City Zoo is now underway. In November, voters in Jackson and Clay counties will be asked to raise the sales tax to pay for the Kansas City Zoo. It would be a two-county tax. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney is covering this for us today. And Michael, what's behind all this?
Well, Kelly, this is a plan to try and put the zoo on steady financial footing, something that it really hasn't had. This is a plan to put it on the ballot in November of this year, on the ballot in two states, a dedicated stream of money. The boosters say it would be generating just over $14 million a year, would also create a special zoo taxing district, and would be governed by an independent body, not by the Jackson County Legislature or the Clay County Commission. Kelly?
And how much would this cost the average taxpayer?
Well, Kelly, it would be 1/8 of 1 penny. And so for every $8 of things that you would buy at the store, it would cost you an extra penny. And as you mentioned, that would generate about $14 million a year. And that is money that they say they can use to put the zoo on a steady financial footing. This is not a new idea. A number of zoo taxing districts exist across the country. For example, the Great St. Louis Zoo on the other side of the state, they have a special taxing district, and they have a dedicated tax fund that they use to support that zoo. In the case of the St. Louis Zoo, it's not a sales tax. They do it on their property tax, Kelly.
Michael, is there a specific plan as far as what they would do with the money?
Yeah, they have a 10-year plan, Kelly, for improvements on the zoo. If this tax is passed, the first thing the zoo boosters and the director here, Randy Wiskoff, says they want to do is create a penguin exhibit, and they think that they could have that up and running in just a couple of years. The goal would be to have it up and open by 2013. Also down the line, they have plans for what they call a big cat canyon, where they would feature all the big cats from all over the world. And then they've got some other things like giraffe expositions and that sort of thing. But they've got a definite 10-year plan they want to implement.
Kelly? Okay. Now, is all this aimed at improving attendance?
Well, attendance really isn't the problem out here, Kelly. They are going to draw somewhere around 700,000 people this year. That's what they expected, and that's what they budgeted for, and their attendance has been going up steadily for the last few years. Really, Kelly, this is about jobs and tourism. There are lots of studies that indicate if a city has a good zoo, it will draw tourists, and if it doesn't have a good zoo, it's just a waste of money. The other thing is they are going to emphasize the jobs, first the construction jobs, building the penguin exhibit, and then the canyon for the cats and all that sort of stuff. And the zoo is also one of the best employers of kids for summer help. In fact, it is the highest, they employ the most kids here from Kansas City on a part-time basis during the summer working at the zoo. So it's going to be jobs and tourism. Those are going to be the keystones on this campaign. Kelly?
Okay. Interesting. Thank you, Michael. Now, the zoo election in Clay and Jackson counties will be this November.